Last week, a group of immigration rights advocates went to commissioner's court asking for answers from the Nueces County Sheriff's Office. They want to know about a program the sheriff's office signed with Immigration and Customs Enforcement. Chris 6 News reporter Greg Chandler has been following this story. He joins us now in the studio with more. Greg.
Priscilla, at the root of the issue is something called a 287G agreement. It refers to a section of the Immigration and Nationality Act of 1996, which allows local agencies to perform immigration enforcement. Those advocates want to know why the Nueces County Sheriff's Office opted in. Members of the Corpus Christi Immigration Coalition say Nueces County sheriffs shouldn't be enforcing federal immigration law.
We did not elect our sheriff to do the job of the federal government. He works for us, and that wasn't the job we elected him to do.
Nueces County Sheriff Jim Kalin disagrees. He says enforcing federal laws is his job.
We enforce federal firearms laws. We enforce federal narcotic statutes. We enforce all kinds of federal laws in addition to state laws.
The Immigration Coalition says Sheriff Kalin promised them he wouldn't enter into a 287G agreement with ICE. But in January, Sheriff Kalin did sign a 287G agreement. The Immigration Coalition says they're simply looking for transparency from Sheriff Kalin. More specifically, they want to know how 287G works. Under 287G, anyone booked in the county jail will have their immigration status checked. If they're here illegally, ICE has 48 hours to pick them up once state charges are settled.
People may be caught up for very minor violations of the law. Does that mean that their lives should be ruined? More importantly, does that mean they should be separated from their families?
Dr. Claudia Rueda believes 287G increases jail costs. Sheriff Kalin argues undocumented immigrants cost taxpayers more.
Your tax dollars go amok in spending resources on people who are not citizens of this country.
According to Sheriff Kalin, 32 people have been turned over to ICE from Nueces County since mid-March, and that was without 287G, which officially went online this afternoon when the jail got access to ICE's system. He says his office isn't going to actively look for undocumented immigrants. 287G just expedites the deportation process. Priscilla?